That top same flame tower, 2 seconds later, they lost it. Didn't make a huge difference for them to go for that, just because Koikva got out, just TP'd out the spin, they weren't able to cancel it. More importantly, they lost Abed mid, they lost that mid tower. Then all of a sudden, that smoke go into that Roche pit was enabled because of that.
Right.
Imagine if they don't lose that mid tower, that kind of smoke is very difficult for Escape to be able to pull off, because then they have to come from the bottom, which is where their Earth Spirit was waiting. Then the further decision to commit the buyback from the Slardar, point it really just felt like they were like, oh man, we're throwing this game, we had this lead, mm-hmm. let's just try to get back into this game, and things just completely spun out of control.
See our draft develop here, Beastmaster and Ogre going the way of Escape. A huge uptick of Ogre recently over the last month and a half. Blitz, what is that all about? This hero is very rarely seen for what, like 2-3 years? You had small periods of time where one or two teams would be like, oh yeah, Ogre's a hero, we'll try that one out. But really a top tier consistent pickup until now.
I think it's just because Valve, they do these little pokes. Mm-hmm. And it was like, okay, Ogre's
like
a bad hero.
Yeah,
they're just little like, pokes. Poke, give it a little bit more regen
Escape
randomly. It's like, here's one more armor, Ogre. And it's like, eventually you can't ignore it.
Uh-huh.
I'm hoping for the same treatment on other heroes.
And is that all? Is it just the small little buff that's given to him? What about his place in the middle? Like, what does he really do for these teams as
a
support?
He bloodlusts you and runs at people.
So he's just a big tanky dummy that soaks up a lot of damage and makes other people fast.
Dude, you don't want to think when you're playing Ogre, because like the moment that you think about this hero, you're like, why am I running into five heroes with only like a single target spell? Can't think about things like that as an Ogre player. You're just like, you let your team think about these things for you. Just like, Ogre, go over there. And you're like, all right, team's all right.
Okay.
You can't question these things.
So you're saying in order to really get into the Ogre Magi spirit, you have to roleplay this hero? Is that what you're saying?
You have to get into like the mentality of heroes.
All right, well, Execration going to respond with a Sand King. Does this mean they're going to try and match the Sand King up against the Beastmaster in a one-on-one situation?
Escape potentially. And it also just gives you options. I think Execration really liked the arrow setup. They weren't really able to get it in that last game just because the Stardar was so far behind. Sand King... Mm-hmm. Range on the sun is okay. More importantly, it's a lot of team fight, and you've already picked two melee heroes on the side of Escape.
Wisp as well as Oracle going to be banned away by Escape, while we'll have the Tinker and Juggernaut taken out by Execration.
Reserve time.
Escape putting a pretty big premium on those really good defensive supports. These are pretty much the best supports that we're seeing when it comes to saving heroes, right? Like, we've mentioned Shadow Demon, we've talked about, obviously, Dazzle had a really big impact this last game, but it seems like Oracle and Wisp are the top two when it comes to the really, truly defensive supports. With most of those gone out of the pool, Escape will take the remaining Dazzle.
I do like the fact that they banned the Oracle. I think that hero is just really annoying to play against, especially in conjunction with that Mirana. We talked about how most Mirana's, especially with that Ags build, your only objective really is just stay alive, because you're going to get damage out no matter what, just as a byproduct of your Aghanims. But by having one of these defensive supports, it makes it so much easier for you to leap in really recklessly and reset things for yourself.
Particularly annoying for some of the offlaners, such as the Batrider, as well as Beastmaster. Beastmaster, obviously, his single target disable easily taken out by the Oracle. Witch Doctor will actually be picked up by Execration. Hero, he certainly saw his heyday earlier this year, but has fallen off recently.
Is this my segue into explaining?
Yes, it is.
Man, I missed that cue.
Please help Blitz Dota. Why did he fall off?
Okay, so the thing about Witch Doctor before is that he just didn't feel very strong. In terms of your teamfight contribution, I know a lot of people will disagree, and they'll say, but in my pub games, I get an Aghanims and I deal 30,000 damage in a teamfight. Well, that's in some ideal game where you just get to farm on a hero like Witch Doctor. In actuality, what ends up happening is you throw out a cask. If anybody has a BKB, you're sitting there, you're a dead target.
10 seconds.
Your stun is very slow. Like, the animation of it is very clearly dodgeable. And more importantly, your ultimate is almost theoretical.
Right,
and hoping it goes off for a while.
This is something that you talked about last game, right? That it seems like people are putting more and more premium on what is reliable rather yep. than the potential damage or the potential disables remaining. That you could see from a hero.
Cool.
And there's the Huskar.
Five
Dazzle Huskar.
Remaining.
Okay, so Execration now... I sort of think you just have to... Whatever idea you had about the Sand King, you might just have to pick something like the AA and... Oh man, this.
Yeah, they're in a rough spot where they have Mirana and Sand King, lot of magic damage, and they're facing up against a Huskar who obviously doesn't care too much about magic damage, coupled with a Dazzle as well as coupled with an Ogre Magi. You've got a lot of tanky heroes here that are just not gonna die.
I'm just laughing. I feel so... You just see that and you're like, Sindarin, you son of a.
They're like, what escape do we do from here? Well, Imbersaw is the answer from Execration. A lot of pure damage. She's even got that Whirling Death to cut down any strength heroes. That's okay, but Huskar can still do a lot of damage to Imbersaw, and you still have Beastmaster with the Necronomicon that are going to be problems for Execration. They need this guy to be rather far.
Remaining.
All right, so what are you thinking? They've got to ban one of these heroes that's kind of annoying. Okay, so they banned the AA. It was AA or...
Turn to ban.
Depends on where they think the Sand King's going to go. I do want to point out that the Timbersaw whole Huskar thing. Timbersaw does okay, but at the end of the day, you get your full combo off and Huskar just kills you anyways. Yeah. If you want proof of this, you look towards
remaining.
Liquid played against OG ESL, ESL Frankfurt.
ESL on Frankfurt,
they
yes.
picked the Timbersaw mid and it did nothing. He executes his full combo. Huskar still has enough HP. He just armlet toggles once, and you die.
And in this case, it's going to be the Dazzle Shallow Grave that'll make sure that Imbersaw won't be able to kill Huskar, and Huskar will just turn around and throw spears really, really quickly.
Man, Sindarin's sick. Like, he just picks a bunch of buffs for this Huskar. He takes Beastmaster
for
the attack speed aura.
He has 2 attack speed increases on a Huskar. Those Burning Spear stacks are going to run up so quickly. So you think that in order to truly combat this, you have to kind of throw a lot of things out the window. Whatever ideas you had about the draft, if you're Execration, you have to throw it out the window as soon as you saw that Huskar. Does that mean you fit an axe into this lineup to try and counter the Dazzle? A Blademail hero that counters Dazzle. Don't have too many other options.
Last time Na'Vi did something like... What did they do? They did the Legion Commander 1 position in hopes of trying to pull out, and that went pretty badly.
10 seconds.
People
remaining.
Have tried to fight this hero head on and it just hasn't worked. But at the same time, you can't go for a split push just because push is the pace of the game so quickly.
Yeah. He's not bad at pushing
reserve
down buildings.
Time.
That's for sure. He just attacks so fast. He's going to take Roshan if you give him enough space.
Sindarin. He's been waiting for this one moment.
Yeah. You devil, you. And there is a Sven, a heavy physical damage dealer. Still not sure how they're going to be able to deal exactly with the Shallow Grave and the Huskar. They're going to need some really sick initiations from the Sand King. But it's looking like we are going to have a Mirana and Witch Doctor as our two supports. Sven farming away at that top lane. Timbersaw mid and Sand King off lane. Or Sand King mid, Timbersaw off lane. How's this work?
I think it depends on what escape
time.
Last pick.
5 seconds.
They have a lot
remaining.
Of options right now.
There's nobody who can really go against that Huskar safe lane though, right?
Ooh, okay.
Koipa's Invoker. Give them a scaling mid just to make sure they've got some good chances still to be able to win the late game if it pushes past 45 minutes. A really good hero at kiting. Sven, do you go Quas Wex if you're matched up against the Timbersaw, or do you still go what has been a bit more preferred in Exort and just farm and split push?
I was thinking about this a lot coming into this tournament because I know some people would pick Invoker, and when I saw the Exort Invoker, I wanted to point out in the last game that I think it's an interesting concept, but at the same time, you know what you get out of Invoker, and teams have just been playing faster and faster, kind of led to him not being as relevant. I think the MVP style of running him is Quas Wex might be where you have to go for this hero to really effectiveness, but for the most part, I almost always just see Koipa play Exort. Like, I don't think I've ever seen Koipa play the Quas Wex. It just doesn't really fit his wheelhouse as a player. Like, you don't think of him as this run around, create space. You think of this guy who's just going to outfarm you and beat you down with his superior presence in teamfights.
He is a he's one of the epitomes of a farming mid for sure, right? So we are going to have our early push out here in game number two, Execration versus Escape Gaming. Already Yapzor, under the guise of smoke, has managed to get himself a very aggressive observer ward in the dire jungle, being able to read the movements of Kimmo on the Morana, and hopefully be able to keep Koifa in a safe place. Also gets a very aggressive mid ward as well. Again, everything to make sure that Koifa has a good time on the Invoker.
Let's talk about the objectives of this game for both teams.
Mm-hmm.
I think for Execration, they need to secure the Sven's jungle stacks. And I think RR needs a really good timing on that Blink Dagger. They can't afford for their main initiating hero in a game like this to be behind at any point in the game. Like, he has to accomplish a lot. Maybe more so than any of the other members of the team. And on the flip side, I think Escape, they have to contest this this ancient stack area, and they have to do it before the Sven can get something that can allow them to teamfight. And then from there, the game becomes very standard. It's all in on this Huskar, right? You just keep buffing him,
yeah,
making him unkillable. You go for the Roshan, and you go for the high ground as a result.
Would you say in that time where Huskar is looked at as one of the scariest, that kind of 20, 25-minute mark, right, where he's in some ways unkillable, he's a monster in team fights, he's pushing down some of your towers. Do Execration just split push? Do you think they actually can contest with the right Blink Dagger pickups?
I don't think you can split push in a game like this, because okay, again, you can simply go for Roshan if you're escaping,
yeah,
go for a push, and they will take down towers so fast, Cap.
Well, they knew it was going to be a Timbersaw mid, so they went ahead and put Era on the Huskar in our mid lane, and we are actually going to be having Koipa farming down at bottom lane. Instead, Abed is already be feeling the burning sensation from those spears as he's trying to get whatever CS he can, but it is gonna be hell to pay every single time he gets a single CS.
He does have some stacks, and that poor man shield's gonna help him out a little bit, but fire is a natural counter to everything.
RR, meanwhile, is our offlaner actually picked up the Iron Talon and tried to go straight jungle, but Escape Gaming are counting that as well. Abed, whew, 7 Burning Spear stacks. He actually pops the healing. Oh, no.
Okay, he's
not the time to pop that healing cell, friend.
I think he thought he was going to die, but
yeah,
it is still only level 1 Burning Spear.
But now he's in a terrible position, has to ferry himself out yet another healing cell just to be able to stay in this lane. It's only going to get worse and worse. They did move Kimmo down to the bottom lane. He was able to pick up an early level 2, and maybe he'll have an impact, but it's at top where we see the Maledict go to work on Kezu. Yapzor is trying to go for Tims at the same time, the boar helping him out, but they're not going to have enough. Yapzor even turning and fighting Nando, knowing that he's just got those amazing level 1 stats that makes Ogre Magi such a great support right now. 8 armor. Not even a carry Sven.
Tick, what is that? Why is that?
Like, why are you even hitting him? It does nothing.
See, Yapzor just kind of like turns off everything he knows about Dota, and he just right-clicks heroes in lane. Look at this hero. He's just kind of getting in the face of 2 other heroes. Doesn't care at all.
So he slowed down the Sand King. He is now being incredibly disruptive in the top lane and freeing up a lot of space for Kezu to be able to get farm. He's having quite the impact in the laning phase so far. The mid lane's not going great, as Era has actually pushed Timbersaw out entirely, it seems. And Abed is going to try and go to bottom lane while the Sand King tries to make the mid lane work instead.
This is not how you wanted this game to start, just because RR is not going to have too much success either. No matter what, you're going to put a melee core in this mid lane. About it. It's
yep,
either going to be the Sven, the Sand King, or Timbersaw. So RR is like, all right, this
Sand
is my life now.
Victory. Alright, well, good luck, friend. Maybe Abed will have a little bit more success at the bottom lane against the Dazzle and Invoker. The time he's here, it's already a level 4 Invoker. Should still be able to make this lane work with the right kind of creep aggro, pulling those reactive armor stacks onto himself, but he's not going to get the amazing CS that he was really hoping for in the mid lane.
The good news for them, though, we talked about how important this Sven was going to be in this game, and Nando is picking up a decent amount of CS despite getting harassed by that Ogre. And he's even going to pick up these creeps right here, as he was just a little bit too late to the party, but he is getting harassed quite badly. And Courier isn't
used. Don't stick around here. Gets off the sandstorm. They actually drop the counter ward. We'll still be able to get the stun. And this is looking to be our first blood. The Burning Spears first takes him out. Yapzor is actually the one to pick up kill off the Ignite.
That's exactly what you want to see an Ogre do. Just get abusive, because it is hard to stop this hero from just running at you. And
he's having quite the level progression as well from this.
And he finds a regen rune.
Like, all right.
This is starting to get rough already.
They'll just keep the pedal to the metal, actually rotating to the bottom lane, and they'll spot out Kimmo. Sitting behind Abed. Yeah, sure. Throws the Ignite over there. Abed tries to push back the supports as best he can, but ultimately, this duo is not going to have much success against a tri-lane of Escape Koipa. Not even needed to help, is just continuing to get as much CS as he can.
So RR is going to come back in this mid lane and try to make things work, but we talked about how important his game was going to be for the initiation. Because if you're Timbersaw, if you think about it, he has to commit that chains to deal damage, because half your spell is you have to get it close for.
Oh, he was hit by the stun, and now he's got a Proto Strike uphill. Looks like he should still be okay. But unfortunately, he is pushed out of the mid lane once again. Arrow will stick around with 237 HP, because that's what a Huskar can do. Look for the stun, top lane. Abed trying to get away with the last bit of HP will be able to. DHP, all that separates him for life and death, will make his way back to the fountain. But again, just like at the mid lane, Escape Gaming may not have gotten the kill, but they have managed to push the hero back, Dyer's and that is still slowing down the laning phase progression of execration.
This sucks to say, but I think they just have to abandon this mid lane, put one of the supports here, and simply just jungle, because you are slowing down your farm too much trying to play conventional Dota. Yapzor.
And it seems like that may not even be an option. They're trying to punish Yapzor, but the arrow nails the creep instead. They're going to try and slow down Yapzor. Fortunately, with the help of Caustic Finale, they might just be able to get this kill, but never mind. It takes them so long to kill Yapzor.
Are you for real, Cap?
Was able to come back in, and yes, the mindlessness of Ogre Magi proves to be superior once again to everything Execration throw at him.
Cap, that man has 8 armor. They are not taking him down. Is he gonna find an arcane rune just to spite everybody?
He's finding the best runes. That region allowed him to go bottom lane. Now
he's gonna throw out 54 mana ignite.
54 mana ignite.
They might even kill Nando.
10.5 seconds. Yeah, they're gonna go for it here. They're already slowing him down with the boar. The ignite is gonna do even more work. They even have a stun ready to go. Nando, he's not gonna survive through this one. RR is gonna try and come in for the stun, but it's not in time. Can't even get the Burrow Strike off. And RR will simply replace the Sven in farming this lane. It seems like, in general, Execration just playing a game of musical chairs, bouncing heroes around from lane to lane.
That is the absolute perfect term to describe what's going on right now, because Execration, because of the draft and that fourth pick Huskar, because they had to commit those two heroes that were so heavy in magic damage, there's no real way for them to swing things. Like, they kind of just have to keep swapping around and hoping a different formula is going to work. But we all know what happens in Huskar games. We saw it during the Starladder Finals when Na'Vi just rolled over. We saw it at a lot of the games at the Summit. And this one doesn't look to be too different, as Execration already at an early deficit. 4,000 gold, 7 minutes.
Their only sliver of hope at this point is Nando, who's got 52 CS, but obviously he's already died as well. He does have that Helm of Dominator. They're gonna try and start stacking things up, but, as you can see, that ancient stack is already being blocked up by a counter ward.
Because they realize this is the only way back into the game for Execration. If you understand that their winning condition is they have to get these stacks off and get that Sven large enough to battle one-on-one against the Huskar, then all you have to do is continuously put Radiant's a body on there. It doesn't matter how many wards you have to commit or how many heroes you have to commit. Do not let this Sven get ancients if you're Escape.
Yeah, they've got two different, not just the counter ward, but two different observer wards placed around that area, just to be able to make sure they have full control of the ancient stack. Execration will not have that opportunity available to them.
They don't care about vision anywhere else on this map, because they know that they're getting so much off of the laning phase, and Execration are reeling from the fact that they can't really do much here.
Mm-hmm. I mean, the Ogre Magi is running around. He's getting a lot of information. Kezu actually fully rotated in. Now, they did fully abandon the mid lane, it seems like. Kimmo, he's going to show himself every once in a while as a support, and looks like he will be the victim Kezu's smoke wrap around his Kimo, unable to get off the leaf in time. They are going to have the Sunstrike over the top, which means Koipa will take the kill. And he's already got the hand of Midas, so his levels and farm already just fine. It's only going to get worse from here for Execration.
Yeah, and there's just nowhere that they can really reliably gank anybody at. This Invoker almost always had that Dazzle behind him. In that top lane, the Beastmaster was supported by that Ogre, who we already talked about, 10 armor on him. Attack. And that Huskar, just, you have to kind of forget about it. He's already got an armlet. So there's no real way for Execration to get back into this game, even by going for any sort of engagement. So they just kind of playing the pace of the game, maybe hope that Escape overextends somewhere.
You don't think they can even, like, just go for something that's, like, really different, like, five-man smoke the bottom lane or something? Like,
that might actually work.
It's just something so off the wall that maybe it catches Escape Gaming by surprise.
They're going to have to do something like that if they're going to stand a chance in this game.
Yeah, because standard play does not look good for Execration.
Yeah. You notice that Zinderin already makes his way up here because he realizes that Huskar is your everything. This is the hero that you want to play around at this point in the game. Koipa will continue to do Koipa things, but even in a 5v4 situation where he's just airstriking with his Sunstrikes, you can win team fights.
He's not going to make the same mistake that we talked about Execration made in game number one, where Abed showed himself in the mid lane. As soon as Escape makes some sort of play on the other side of the map, Koipa immediately backs up the jungle and even plays even more defensively. Playing near the tier 2 at mid. Tims is going to be jumped on here. The Sunstrike going to be off the mark because Kezu unfortunately couldn't get off the Primal Roar in time to line that one up. But still, hit the kill nonetheless and might just be able to get Nando as well. He's trying to make a play, cutting through between the tier 1 and tier 2. Runs into Koipa, manages to get off the stun, but now is blocked in by the Force Spirits. Excellently played by Koipa, trapping Nando. And Syndra. Players will take the kill off the Shadow Wave bomb.
And I really like the fact that they're just leaving Era up here to continue to get solo XP. Because the one thing that could slow them down is if they split up, or if they group together too much, they might just get behind in levels, which is what we're seeing with this Dazzle, who's only level 5, as opposed to the level 6 Witch Doctor. But at the same time, they understand the strength of the lineup. Once again, they can just ball around this Huskar, and there's not a whole lot that Execration can do. I think Execration is making the correct play here. They went for this bottom area like we talked about in the last game, how important it is for Dire to just invade Radiant jungle. The problem is the payoff just isn't as strong in this game.
They didn't manage to catch any heroes lurking there in the bottom lane like earlier. Maybe they could have caught Koipa or something like that, but Escape had fully abandoned the lane by its time Execration made that kind of rotation, and they only get a tier 1 in exchange for the tier 1 that had already been taken by Escape at top lane.
I think they really just need some sort of wombo combo off of this Witch Doctor ultimate into the Sand King ult when he eventually gets a Blink Dagger. Like, I'm racking my brain so hard right now.
Yeah, you're looking 10 minutes in the future because everything before that is all doom and gloom for Execration, and there's no other way we can really get around that.
Yeah, I know.
Can't
my job
really
in a
sugarcoat this one.
Job in a game like this is to try to figure out a way for Execration to, you know, get back into this, but like, this is sometimes just what happens in a Huskar draft. It's like, they're even going to find a DD rune, and they're probably just going to go for Roshan right now, because they know that there's no Blink Dagger available on that Sand King.
In which case, Execration have very small chance to be able to fully interrupt a Roshan attempt. They are going to cut Abed across here behind the tier 1 at top lane and see if they can take that. Now, that'll obviously mean that Escape get a free Roshan, but hey, we already said that Execration can't contest any win anyway, so if they can just get a little bit of gold in their coffers in exchange for that Roshan, that is at least something to work with.
Yeah, this is a take what you can get situation. And that stack that we were talking about of the Ancients still not available, and that is the whole reason why you mix Smiles. Now this is where the Doom push comes in, as Execration, they're just gonna, they scan, they confirm what they already knew as Roshan falls, and now they are gonna sit behind this bloodlusted Huskar.
Double damage as well.
And alacrity.
Still going on. And alacrity. Oh man, we forgot about Dyer's that one. Tower. Two attack speed increases from the Beastmaster Aura as well as the Ignites. And with that last big Invoker, now have alacrity damage increase as well as attack speed. And sure enough, 13 minutes in with an Aegis, Escape Gaming will push high ground, and Execration do not have the tools to really get a good initiation to threaten Escape. They still don't have the Blink Dagger.
They can't really fight this. Like, their Sven has no way to gap close. They don't really have Dyer's a save for him either. Like, if he commits attack with the God Strength, at that point, it's do or die situation. They're gonna pop the Murana ultimate, but it's gonna get spotted out, and RR was farming mid. And Escape are just gonna sit behind the Sagus and essentially dare Execration to make a move on Era. So many buffs coming on, the Weave, the Alacrity, the Bloodlust.
And puts Inner of Vitality on himself just to make it easier. Kimmo is going to be the first target spotted out there. Taken out from a blast from the Ogre combined with the Primal Roar. Those two being down, maybe Execration will have a moment's respite, but it doesn't look like it. Era actually looking rather healthy. The Timbersaw is trying to slow him down as best he can, but it looks like an Inner Vitality will actually outdo the damage of the Chakram. And they're rapidly running out of mana. Tier 3 tower down. This only gets easier for Escape as they now push against the Raxes. They haven't even hit that 15-minute marker. The ranged Rax already down. Melee Rax coming up next. Execration still not making the initiation because they just don't see a window. They sell everything for RRB. We'll pick up the Blink Dagger, gets the jump on Era, but it doesn't result in anything. He actually turns, jumps onto Nando. Might just be able to finish mom with one more swing. Nando can't get away. The Burning Spears are too much for him to handle. And Era, a beast, still has not died. The Shallow Grave saves his life and keeps the Aegis intact.
They have so much gold now. Execration still without a kill in this game. 10,000 gold lead, experience drifting in a similar position. And they are probably scratching their heads right now, trying to keep their TI hopes alive, continuing to farm whatever they can before the next assault comes, but they only really reasonably get another chance at this because this is a 15-minute double Rex.
Ill-gotten gains.
A full-on halberd is coming in now for our Huskar. So a very early big strength increase, as well as now you have a disarm to play against the Sven, as well as an evasion chance.
Yeah, they'll just do the same thing again. They'll play behind this Huskar, similar to what they did with the Tiny and the Healing Ward.
How do you buy yourself time as Execration? 2 minutes until the Aegis goes down. Maybe Escape won't push high ground if that Aegis is intact, but how do you buy yourself 2 minutes?
I think you just have to take a fight right now. Doesn't matter what it looks like at this point, you can't afford to get a second set of racks down at just 16 minutes into the game. Era deals too much damage. You hope for a dream fight right now with RR and this Witch Doctor, and they're smoked up. They're looking for it. Here he goes.
The jump in, Epicenter straight on through, the Pro Strike only landing onto Era. They pop the God Strength. Looking to be able to finish Era off, but they already have the Shallow Grave down, and Execration forced to retreat. Find themselves some time, Tim's going to work with that Death Ward, and they will be able to take him out. Aegis down, and Era rather deep inside the base. RR thinking about slowing him down with a Pro Strike. No, actually doesn't go for it, just hoping that Escape will themselves run away, making this job a whole lot easier for Execration. Double stun, Chakram on the way in, but can't finish up the creeps, and Escape will continue to beat on this melee Rax. It's going to be two lanes of Rax down before the 20-minute marker, as it seems Execration have run out of steam once again.
Yeah, even with the Aegis down, without any of the ultimates available, there's no way that they can take this fight. For them, they don't have any casualties on their side, as nobody goes down for their troubles, but still, losing a Rax in that kind of fashion is going to be pretty disheartening, as I think Escape can just continue to do what they've been doing and go for this top tower. If they really want to secure this game, they can just wait for the next Roshan and reset.
Look at the way Escape put themselves very defensively behind Era. Were not in range of that Epicenter one bit. All they had, the only target available for Execration when it came to the initiation, was Era on the front lines, and that just meant only an Aegis would go down, and Execration did not have an opportunity for any follow-up past that.
That's disciplined play. Like, they present the target of Era. They said your only condition for winning this game anymore is if the Sand King gets a multiple hero Epicenter off. So they take away that possibility entirely.
Now have a Blink Dagger for the Huskar, so he Dyer's can go ahead and pull attack a little Seek and Destroy if he wants to, and pursue Execration all the way into the back lines. But first, gonna take down this Tier 2 and go for the Siege onto the Tier 3. Epicenter is back up. They're gonna go for the smoke once again. Wrap around, see if they can find a better target than Era.
They've got to get this backline if they're going to have any success in this team fight.
Once again, Escape are keeping themselves pretty well spread. The epicenter about to go in, blinks in, and they'll be able to make the jump on a Koi, but the follow up there from Ahmed, but it's just not quite enough damage. RR gets ripped a new one, and so does Ahmed. He makes a long jump in across to the trees, but he burns away, and Koifa will take the last hit. It all just comes down to Nando with the full god strength, but that is it. A total shutout here in game number two, as Escape Gaming will be your 16th team here at the International.
Congratulations to Escape. Condolences to Execration, as I thought they played very well in their previous two series, but made a few errors in game one that just made it impossible for them to win, and in game two, just think it was a straight outdraft. They did the best with what they could with their lineup, but at the same time, not a whole lot to do once they saw that Huskar.
Absolutely. It seems